They called us low income. They called us at risk. Always speaking from a deficit, didn't realize that my learned experience was prerequisite to be a leader in this community. How could you ever really know unity if you've never seen the broken? They tried to slam the door shut, but my man Tim held it open. See, they forgot to call us scholars. Forgot to call us knowledge dip sociologist, unapologist, polished with dreams of being our brother's keeper long before it was common in politics. See, we were the seeds that nobody expected to be trees, but we tend to supersede expectations, defy statistics, never standing complicit. See, leaders aren't just in our titles, it's synonymous with our existence. We were the roses that grew from the concrete, became the garden that grew from the ghetto, became the forest that grew from the forgotten, proceeded without caution, never waited to blossom. See, this is the part of the story where somebody finally saw them. It started in a garage. Humble beginnings in this early stage where teachers who cared worked extended days without extended pay just to see their students walk across that prestigious stage and not holding regular diplomas. No, see, these were degrees for change. They gave us the tools, watered our seeds, never looked surprised at what their investment would bring. A network full of leaders from the Hill to the CD, educated and ready to meet the city's needs. We changed campuses, brought perspectives to private schools, navigated the unspoken rules of colleges that weren't built for us. With stories too unique for the common application, collected determination in a cadre of formation, we made an impact that could only be measured in scientific notation. We became teachers, preachers, scientists, activists, counselors, lawyers, employers, nonprofit founders, and PhDs. But ultimately, when watered, we became trees. A wise person plants seeds so the descendants will know shade. The investment that was made receives returns every day. What started as little ripples has now become waves, and generational trajectories have been completely changed. Now this is community development. And it doesn't start with tall buildings, renovations are detaining our youth. It starts with homegrown leaders unafraid to speak their truth, able to bear fruit because they're connected with deep roots to a city that raised them and respects what they do. When a community stands together, the mountains become movable. Lights in the collective are too bright to be dimmed. We didn't love our communities because they were beautiful. Our communities are beautiful because we love them. So don't call us anything that starts with a deficit. Call us scholars. Call us leaders, call us change, call us trees, and discover what happens when you decide to water a seed. Call us the future and watch us as we continue to bear fruit in what they told us was the desert.